fuck you think you're fucking with, I'm the fucking boss. 745, white on white, that's fucking Ross. I cut them wide, I cut them long.
Thank you. Thank you very much. I love it. I love the sound when these go like this. Now, I should warn you that
there's no cues.
There's no cues.
No A's to be
there's
given.
No questions. Laura from work. This is a genre of Q&A now. They have printed out instructions for a game that we are going to play as the Q&A. I'm just gonna read the instructions and then hopefully, I'm just gonna read the instructions. Hi fellas, this game is controlled by a videotape. It is a race against time and against the game's host, the gatekeeper. Once you start the tape, the game begins and cannot be paused or rewound, Kris. Remember.
You know I never rewind.
Listen. Remember, no pausing or rewinding. The gatekeeper considers it cheating and wins the game by default. You have 60, oh shit, it's time. You have 60 minutes to play, but once the tape reaches 60 minutes, the gatekeeper wins. Your starting places are marked on the board and your pieces are already set.
Okay. So I'm this little
yes, this little munchkin here,
guy.
Kris and Jerry. Okay.
All right.
You actually have a you can actually see it. Okay, this is what we're seeing. Well, not the other thing. That's not, we don't see that. We see this.
I'm seeing it now.
And so it's called Mike Mare. So that's some powerful branding already. Please thank Tabletop Dynasties out on the show floor for providing these lovely dice charms. I've got a wicked owl bear,
this
and you've got
like
some
Cthulhu.
Yeah, a little Cthulhu, Marvy.
Oh, he's grabbing a percentile die right on there.
What's he? What's he doing?
Yeah, he's holding a percentile.
Oh hell yeah!
There he is.
That's what I'm talking about.
There
Before
he
you
is.
Start, roll your d6. Whatever number you roll is your number.
Okay.
4 and 2.
All right.
Anytime the gatekeeper references your number, or you see it on the board, that's what it means.
Okay.
They mean your number you just rolled. Okay.
The 2 for me.
The 4 for me.
As evidenced here.
Yeah, exactly, behold.
This is easy.
There, once you've identified your player piece and rolled your number, shout into the void. Don't do it.
Not yet.
Roll the tape and the tape will begin. The aim of the game is to collect all three of your character's boxes of words.
Oh.
So moon, apocalypse, zombie, Poe, UFO, and conspiracy. This is fucking crazy.
I feel like all of these constitute conspiracy.
Yes,
like,
exactly.
That's the superset.
This entire thing constitutes a conspiracy. Okay. This is the parenthetical. The aim of the game is to collect all your shit, like I said, and then race to the center of the board and answer plain, Aussie, or dark questions along the way.
Oh, that's where the questions are. It's still a Q&A.
Ha ha! All right, once you shout, roll the tape, turn the page. Roll the tape!
Do we have to look up here to address the grave man or whatever he is?
So, I'm not really live from inside your television set. Listen, I've seen your other Q&As and like they're cute and everything, but it's nothing like how we used to do it. What do you do crafts now? You solve little puzzles instead of doing art? I'll give you art, okay? You're in my game show now, baby. That's right, you're little babies. You're little daddy. So listen up, time's ticking. This is my game. If you manage to finish the game before the clock hits 60, you win. But if time runs out, I win. And your souls are bound to me for all eternity.
Oh. Bro!
Oh yeah, while you're here, I should tell you, every time I say, how's it swinging? You gotta stop what you're doing and yell, I love it, Daddy. I love it. Get me? I love it, Daddy. I love it.
I love it, Daddy. I love it. Okay.
You really love it? Tell Dad.
I love it, Daddy.
Now, you don't have to do it perfectly every time, but just understand that if you don't, I will know. You'll have to move to the black hole, or you have to stay until you roll a 6 to play again. Anyway,
no.
Start rolling dice, picking up cards, because time.
They didn't even count that toward, like,
you
it didn't
asshole.
Start. God.
Right now we're already down a fucking minute and a half. Here, listen. If you hit a black hole, you have to roll a six to play again to be released by Mike.
Okay, these are the
these
holes
black
right
holes.
There.
Okay, it says black hole on it. That's easy. You must follow his instructions exactly every time. I love it, Daddy. I love it. Is that what I'm supposed to say?
Yeah.
All right. Each turn, roll your d6. Move that many squares clockwise.
Hey, fellas.
What the? We love it.
I love it, Daddy.
We
love it.
Jerry, that was cassette.
Ow.
Chris, do that again. That was amazing.
I love it, Daddy. See?
Get in the hole, Jerry. I don't want to hear it another one.
What a blessing.
What the fuck? This game's trash.
From the diaphragm. Okay.
Well, here, we'll just roll. I'm gonna roll a d6 and try to get a six so I can get the fuck out of here.
Kay.
That's a four.
Okay, you got a four.
Yes. All right, no, you must land on the Mike Mayer square by the exact roll. So we're gonna be going around, going around.
Loop and loop.
It's a Parcheesi thing. All right, ready?
Yeah, let's begin.
So go ahead and roll and let's get some shit popping.
Okay, I got a four as well.
Yep.
So I move my guy.
Mm-hmm.
Boink, boink, boink. Boink, take a box if you're number five. I am not, so.
All right.
I think it defers to you.
Shove it up your ass.
Oh, wait, yeah, at what point do we grab the, or does it say, okay.
They're marked on the board. That's a four. All right, continue. We gotta go fast, Kris, fast.
Why do you not move on a four?
Because I have to roll a six because of-
Oh, you have to escape
Because of Mike's
the,
fucking
You got
bullshit.
In the hole right away. One.
Aussie.
We'll see. All right, let's see. All right, ready to do it.
Yeah.
Jamie Council from Dunedin, Australia. In 2012, you developed an iPhone app called the Air Hornsman. Why? Follow-up question, why? Because we thought it was funny and it was a horn. And it goes, woo, and it's fun to have that.
Nerd. That's the opposite of a six.
All right. I'm gonna clean up. I'm the favorite boy. Am I looping like that?
Well, let's see.
No, that doesn't
Here,
make sense.
Clockwise.
Oh.
We can't go into the middle yet.
Oh, right. Okay. Well, yeah. I'm already going this way,
yeah.
So I screwed it up.
So now go back this way and just start doing it right.
Okay.
It's never too late
two,
to do things
three,
correctly,
four,
you
five.
Piece
I'm back
of
on
shit.
Kris. Where's the Kris card?
Go.
Two as well. Boink, boink. Take a box if you're number six. I am not.
Yeah. Go.
Two. Oh, that hole. Another Aussie card. A trumpet in a punk band from probably in a playlist your friends won't like asks, do you like ska? Nope. Four again. Ooh, big six.
Oh yeah,
Let's
six
see
is for everybody else.
One, two, three, four, five, six.
Dark card.
Spike from Australia's coolest city asks, have you bought Mike's presents yet? Is it hard to shop on such a large budget? Have you considered buying multiple gifts just to be safe?
For Mike?
For Mike, I guess.
Mike,
he has everything. He's about to have everything.
Mike, yeah, exactly. He's about to have our souls in addition because he's a piece of shit. Six.
Nice.
All right. Now, I have to roll to play again or be released by Mike. Now, do I move now or am I free? Move.
Oh, you can move. Okay, great.
We love it. One, two, three, four, five, six, the number of the beast.
It's another hole.
Plane. Franco Caso from Brunswick and Footascray. Do you generally buy Steam games when they are first released, or do you wait for a grand sale, grand sale, grand sale?
It's local, local flavor.
No, I 100% purchase them as they come out because I have poor impulse control. All right.
As an aside, may we have water out here?
Are you thirsty?
I need a little,
yeah.
A little.
Your pollen is something else.
Plain. Boring old plain. Harry Chen from Singapore asks, I have read Penny Arcade religiously since 2004.
Got him.
If you ever open a new international PAX, would you please consider Southeast Asia? We
Ooh.
Have access to all the weird Chinese technology shit that doesn't work very well.
Okay, I think that would be a blast. Oh, thank you so
thank
much.
You. Thank you. Thank
Honestly,
you.
I am looking for the barest hint of an excuse. Next time I come down here, I just want to be... in this part of the bulb.
Hey, Kris, roll the die
for me. Oh, shit!
Oh, okay, let's roll it. Okay, yes, yep. Sir. Yes, Daddy.
That's the number of turns.
Oh!
Oh, four. I missed four turns.
This piece of
So it's fair. You were in a hole for a long time.
1, 2, 3, 4. Ozzy. From asks, take a box of words. You've earned it.
Is that legal? Is it legal?
Conspiracy. It feels good. It feels right. Next of your four turns.
So I skipped one.
6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. More Ozzy. Can't get enough. From asks, get out of the black hole, ya drongo.
Are these shuffled?
Well, but honestly, like, because I had to move and answer a question, I think you get out of the, oh, you're not in the black hole.
I'm not in a hole.
No, you've been trapped by Mike.
This is some of his machinations. I'm at his mercy.
1, X.
Oh yeah, it was X. X. Oh wait, if you get, it's not on there, is it?
It's fine. X.
It's just for color.
Yeah, it's fun.
We just like.
Or it might be important later. 1, 2, 3, 4. Take a box for your number 6, I'm not. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, plane.
Okay, so now I'm out of the hole.
Max from Gimpy. Gimpy? All right. I was like, is it Jimpy? Nah. Jerry, you are a deck builder aficionado. Did Blizzard perfect the genre with Hearthstone, or are there innovations that are yet to appreciate and or steal? Hearthstone is Magic fan fiction. So no, they did not perfect the genre with Hearthstone. Here's what I'll tell you. I think that there's really, really interesting things happening, specifically where CCGs are in Japan. You should check out Card Fight Vanguard over at the Neko Cards booth in the tabletop section. Yes.
There we go. Big one. Blank.
Yeah.
No X on this one.
5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Hey, what's up, Kris? How you doing?
Grave buddies.
Hit it.
2 for me. Another X. See, now I feel like there's got to be something about these X's.
Well, maybe it's in the expansion pack. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Dark. Hoo-hoo. Nick Papadopoulos from Oakley asks, which of you would win a quick draw pistol duel at high noon?
Ugh. I mean, we both need corrective lenses at this point.
Yeah, no, at this point, I think that we would empty both weapons.
And live.
And then live. We were the only two people who would turn a midnight duel into a co-op game.
Take a box of your 4, I am not empty.
You're not. Toi. Take it.
Actually, why should I'll make it easy on myself. I'll put my glasses on.
You're playing in hard mode.
Another one, and then, it's your starting space.
Do you have to interact with me in some way?
Hi, Jerry.
Oh, shit. What?
I was just swinging.
I love it, Daddy.
I do.
You know what? Great job, buddy. If you weren't already out of the hole, go on, get out. And put Kris in there.
What? Oh, sinister. I'll choose the closest hole.
Dude, local holes in your area.
I always do.
I got myself. Thrum asks, this entitles you to one round of hip hip hooray from the crowd, facilitated by your counterpart. So go ahead and get into that.
Hip hip.
Hooray!
Hip hip.
Hooray!
Hip hip.
Hooray!
Wow.
That's nice.
That feels surprisingly
really nice.
Good. Here.
All right, can I get out of this hole? Nope.
Nope. You're gonna be spending a lot of time in that hole.
What's it like?
Oh, fuck. Okay.
It's
maybe,
a roll off.
Maybe I jumped in a little bit too early there.
Nope.
Duh. Oh, the number of the fucking beast.
He got out.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, plong. Meg from Corumbra. It's a different spelling, okay. Cambra. VR felt like the future in 2016, didn't it, Just? I remember a 3D TV. Its dominance was inevitable. In the end, it was just Beat Saber. Why did it fizzle out? Oh, because sometimes a significant percentage of people, when they put it on, throw up in real life.
Yeah, imagine a whole medium that you can't use unless
that's
you get
inextricable
sick.
From vomit.
Yeah.
Oh, the number of the beast. Join me on plane, bro.
Plane is. Oops. Here you go.
I'm bored. This is very boring. I want you to answer the next question like you're at a tent revival. Praise him, hallelujah.
Burke from Burke Road asks, Jerry, my high school English teacher gave us 2 sources to read routinely if we wanted to learn to write well. One is the obituaries in The Economist. The other is your posts on Penny Arcade. If you had to name a third, what would it be?
I didn't understand the question either. I was too concentrating on the spirit.
Kitchen Confidential from Anthony Bourdain.
Praise that confidential. Hallelujah.
Take it away.
I may do it the rest of the game just because I like to sound like that.
Oh.
One. That's it.
Oh, Ozzy.
Ozzy.
Jared Roughhead from Hawthorne asks, which AFL team do you support? Don't say Collingwood. Beware, most Victorians will quietly judge you harshly if you say none. No,
those are the ones, yes. That one team has a lot of nicknames.
I support the Canberra Cassowaries.
Go Cassowaries.
I think it was a real team. Judged.
Bonk, bonk. Nothing for me.
All right. Boop, boop. Oh. Duck.
Duck, God.
Duck. Ray Baby from Fraser Island asks, what is something you are glad you did once, but never want to do again for the rest of your life? Have three girlfriends at the same time. Listen, this is before apps. If I had been able to schedule it, maybe it'd be different.
Ozzy.
But if you ever end up in this situation, I do have a tip for you.
Pause the VHS, please.
You want to settle on a single pet name.
And it shouldn't be one of their names, unless they're all the same name.
Yeah, that's a lot of work. I mean, okay. Hit it.
Yeah, you have to check that field. All right, Bubble O Bill from the streets asks, I have always wanted to try a Butterfinger, a Payday, or a $100,000 bar. Did you bring any with you? Are they amazing? I will say.
We do have some, actually.
Yeah, but like the Payday is fine. 100 grand is fine. Butterfinger is okay. Also, it sticks to you forever. It just gets into all of the crevices.
It becomes a member of the family.
It's like an elephant's molar, like a flat surface in the mouth. It's like cement.
It's more of a grinding tool.
Yes.
Oh. Hit it.
Oh. Where's my die? We're just,
join
we're just
me.
Neck and neck. All right.
1, 2, 3, 4. Ozzy. Oi, oi, oi. Andrew from Melbourne asks, Halloween has never really caught on here, despite our best efforts. Our equivalent is a lame school event called Book Week. That books aren't lame.
Wow.
Andrew, books kick ass. Maybe you're lame.
Yeah, maybe you're the book.
Yeah, maybe you're the Book Week. is trick-or-treating really as big as it looks in America, like in E.T.? Do kids actually do tricks? Hell no. Kids will definitely, they will do tricks. Like, if you are stupid enough to put the candy out front in a bowl because you are too lazy to give it, my kids will put the whole thing in their pillowcase.
That's your job to stop them, though.
No.
All right, 4, 1, 2.
It's
three.
Called the dad tax, and they are familiar with it. Ah!
Hey, Kris.
Yes.
How's it swinging?
I love it, Daddy. I love it.
I gotta tell you, I respect you as a fellow artist, as a creative, and as a coworker. You do incredible work. And I'm really blown away by what you make.
Where's the turn?
But that sucked. Get in the hole.
Oh.
Dude, you're spending a lot of time in this fucking hole. Like, a lot of these clips are just about you going in the hole. Have you noticed this?
Yeah, apparently. Which game is this? This is Kris Mare.
I'm on the Kris space, and it feels great.
Nice. Yeah, when can we begin to orbit into the central area?
Well, here.
Done a lap.
I got it here. Let's see, if you get a question, answer to the best of your ability. You must land on the Mike Mare Square by an exact roll. Once you reach the Mike Mare Square, you enter the final challenge.
Well, honestly, like, we have to judge it anyway. It's not like we can always go in.
Oh, exactly.
So we have to figure out.
By landing on this stone, you have released all those in the black hole. So we could go in if we wanted.
I see. Okay.
Is that what it seems like?
Here. Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, we need boxes, right?
Yeah, oh, that's true. We didn't get any boxes yet. All right, I'm 3. 1, 2, 3 is dark.
Oh, we need boxes for the final challenge.
Oh, that's right. I'm in the hole.
You're in the
I'm
hole.
Sorry.
Shut up your ass.
I'm sorry.
Roll it. Just try to get a number that is.
Nah,
the,
I still got a three.
The beast
so skip
number.
Skip it.
Oh, dark. William Scott from Planet Earth-ish asks, the question is this, given that God is infinite and the universe is also infinite, would you like a toasted tea cake? Yes, absolutely.
Nope. It's to you.
All right, here. So we could, if we hit this, so if you hit this, then you have to go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
Yeah, but then you end up just, you might just loop. Oh. Well, if you're here and you roll a one, I think you're in business.
Yes, that's
yeah.
true. 4. Oh, all right, wait, you're in. You have to roll
oh, you
six.
Did already? Okay.
Yep. Nope.
Yeah, 4.
6. See, I got 6s to spare. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Plant. St. J.W. from the chat, from the Isle of Wight, asks.
Height.
Haviget. UK asks, the Isle of Wight hosted a festival in 1970 that featured Hendrix, The Doors, Supertramp, etc. There is now an Isle of Wight festival, and although it does have some awesome bands on occasion, Pearl Jam, Neil Young, Foo Fighters, REM, the lineup has been pretty meh of late. What would your perfect festival lineup be? Who would headline the whole thing? Well, here.
That's a tough one.
No, it's not.
For me, it's a tough one.
Here, let's just go here into the...
Just make a playlist now.
The recent. Yeah, exactly.
Just play
I made one called Air. It's for this. Okay, so the opening act is Megadeth. Then, after that, we have Phoebe Bridgers.
Okay.
Mitski.
Okay.
Beach Bunny, Girl in Red. And then the headliner is Pete and Baz.
Look!
I don't want to alarm you, but there is, like... a huge spider on you. No, don't look at him. No sudden movements. Now just answer the next question.
Okay. Once one occurs. Nope. I'm still in this hole.
All right, now, I want to make sure.
I'm not in the hole with the spider.
Exactly. So you move that many squares clockwise. Every piece of the gravestone is a square, and you can occupy the same square. If you hit the black hole, you're stuck there until you do the thing that releases you. If you get a question, answer it. I just want to make sure. So is it our choice to head in there at any time?
I assume so, but like then...
Because we could wrap this thing up fast, but we need boxes.
We need boxes. So I feel like there's a mechanism to collect boxes that we're missing.
Exactly. Hey, but by landing on this, I've released all those who are in the black hole.
Oh, delighted to be out. All right, so then I will exit it with this roll.
Yes.
0, back in the hole. And 2, here's an X for me. Yeah, it seems to me that collecting boxes only if you land on the single one of these that is yours.
Yeah, but there's other box forever. Opportunities, as you've seen. For example, I've got a great box right here.
That's true.
Brosephine, from the land of, surprisingly, a lot of smoke and fire, a.k.a. the Pacific Northwest USA, actually legit, that's true. What commercial jingle gets stuck in your head most often? Also, you're welcome. Everyone else who will now have it stuck in their heads for the rest of the convention. Yeah, but see, you have different ones. The
That's
first
right.
time I was here, I heard this Vegemite song a lot. And it seems like basically everybody knows this Vegemite song. But here, I can tell you what it is though. It's grab a stick of juicy fruit. The taste is gonna move ya. Grab it, take a sniff, pull it out.
Beep, meow.
The taste is gonna move you when you pop it in your mouth. Juicy fruit, it's gonna move you.
It's gonna
chew so soft, it gets right to you.
God, I haven't thought about
Juicy
that in
fruit.
A long time.
The taste is gonna move you.
I forgot that. Take a sniff,
yeah.
Pull it out. It's gross. It was a simple time back then. 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, dark.
Duh.
The monster under the stage, from under the stage. Asks, what do you both feel are the best methods to introduce horror elements to a tabletop RPG session?
Oh, as the world's foremost master of tabletop horror.
Geez, I don't know. I think that it's cool to make such a like a switch in the emotion. Like everybody was going nuts last night. There was a lot of goofing around at the table.
It was silliness.
But when
and then
it
you
was,
like stab,
but
and then
when
you
it
just
was
when
time,
you stab Laura.
Yeah, you just stop. You just say, no, we're done. Yeah, it's just a hard turn.
Yeah.
Okay, no, that's you. Ooh, it's getting so bad. It's by the hour mark, it's just gonna be like screeching.
Yeah. Jonathan Frakes from TV's Roswell asks, ever been mountain biking? Yes.
Yeah.
Thank you. Thank you for asking, Jonathan Frakes.
It's pretty cool. Plane for me. Thank you. Jeff Raven from Club PA. Wait, Kris has a Patreon too? Asks, I finally obtained your Brute Hollow books and I've read the first one. It's awesome. My question is about the last page. You mentioned being afraid of the dark since 2001 A Space Odyssey on Betamax. Was it something about the film or did your family invest heavily in Betamax only to see it fail 8 years later? Yeah, we lost it all. It was a superior format, smaller form factor.
It's obviously the resolution, it's richer.
No, I watched it too young. My dad was the first thing he bought for that machine, and I watched it or parts of it when I was like three.
It's scary.
And there's a lot of like jump cuts and like eye imagery.
And scary music.
And scary music.
And Hal.
And you don't, and I didn't know what was going on.
No,
and it
no.
just stayed with me.
No, you would basically be remixing it in your mind, because none of that stuff is hooked into anything else. You know, I think about fucking evolution.
No, it's just images that are scary to a child. It was rough. But I mean, I love the movie.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I'm safe.
Okay, here we go. Big one, nothing. There
feels
you go.
Feels right. Feels free. Oh, plane. Kevin from...
Uh-oh. Imitate the actions of a tiger. That's all it is. I don't have any more. Once you're done answering the question, you have to ask the audience to applaud to let you roll. Or boo, and you go back in the hole.
Mm.
Don't think about skipping that part. Oh, no.
Dang. What? No.
Not yet.
Not yet.
Not yet.
We need to get the VU meter so we can figure out.
Kevin from Wollongong asks, Wollongong?
Oh,
I'm gonna get booed, aren't I? Oh, no, Wollongong?
Wall of Gong. Just do it.
Wollongong.
he got it.
Kevin from that place asks, my wife offered me a contract, 10 hours of uninterrupted gaming per week if she gets another baby.
What?
We already have two kids. Should I sign it? Yes!
No.
All right, now.
That doesn't sound like a partnership. I don't like it.
Applaud.
I don't like it.
Okay. It doesn't sound like a whole situation for me. I'm loving it.
No, we enjoyed it. One again, but I can answer an Aussie question. Angus McDonald from Places asked, Kris, can you share with us any FTL drive ideas you have? It seemed you cut yourself off at PAX West, but we must know more. No, you cut me off. And it was a smart thing to do, because I could go for a long time on it. Oh, but I won't give any, but I did try to come up with a unique sublight drive for all of the PAX ships.
Oh,
so
really?
They, each one is different.
Oh,
but
so
they all use loop drive.
Yeah, but it's a chiral?
Yeah, hyper-chiral.
Hyper-chiral drive?
Yeah.
Gotcha.
Where you take two opposing forces.
The drive
forces.
Segment is the same for each ship, right?
Right, yeah.
Two. Aussie.
Two.
Bridget, Rotnest?
Come on, have some respect.
What would you say is the most famous Australian band or musical act ever? At least where I am from, it would be, oh God. Silverchair is from here, isn't it? I didn't hate that first song, actually. It did sound like other songs, but they were like 3 years old. The most famous Australian band probably in the United States is INXS. Not the Wiggles. but I was always partial to Midnight Oil.
Four.
They got some hot beds.
Oh, look. Boing, 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 boing. Take a box if you're number two, which I am.
Oh, you are. Which box are you trying to get?
I'm going to go with Moon.
Moon.
Are we supposed to open them?
I mean,
I don't
expect, hang on.
I don't expect there to be a moon in here.
Here.
Yeah, that's what I thought. This is they're related to the final.
My suspicion is that you've already cheated.
No. You're eight. Six.
The number of the beast.
Nothing. No fun questions. Oh, good. Okay.
Choo-choo-choo.
You're spared.
Ah!
How's it swinging?
I love it, Daddy.
I need you both to roll. Whoever has the higher number, answer the next question as if you currently have Tweety Bird in your mouth. Whoever has the lower number, you get a box of orange.
Ooh.
Enjoy.
You rolled a 7. All right, well, I'll suspend that until I get a question.
Yes.
Okay. I forget whose turn it is, though.
You just meant? I'll go.
Okay, go ahead.
Yeah.
Come on, big money. 1, 2, 3, X. Nothing there.
Ciao. 1, 2, 3, 4. Take a box for your number 3, which I am not.
Dang.
Dark.
Number 3, dark. All right, here we go. Here we go. Joy McHusband from Spacecom.
Joy McHusband?
Yeah. Asked, Mike has retreated to space to... But I was supposed to answer it. I'll do it. Mike has retreated to space to escape the crowds and continue making art. Years later, mysterious illustrator crashes near Neptune to threaten humanity, requiring an upgrade patch. Which one of you will bring the update to Mike, and what disasters might befall you? I don't know.
Me either.
How would I be able to bring him an upgrade? I'll bring him another ship. I will bring him a supercontinental warship from the first Q&A.
Yeah, from the first Q&A.
That'll take care of it, and then we bring his ship into it and that lump of gold I got. That I get to keep, that's
exactly,
mine.
It's yours.
That I can have.
Did you see that story about that? It's essentially like a catapult. It's like another way of getting things into orbit that doesn't require like the rocket. And it spins it at 5,000 miles an hour and then just throws it into space.
Yeah.
Hell yeah, it's real.
This is the kind of thinking we need.
Yeah, we need somebody to think about something that involves not burning one-of-a-kind compounds 24/7.
Well, you got Aussie, right?
Yep. Foodomancer from Melbourne asks, have you tried HSPs yet? See, that's how you know. And if you so, will you expand your horizons and try KSPs? That's not real, right?
What are they? What are they all
I know what
over?
I got this.
Yeah, thank you.
I know what a HSP is. So you have to understand, the enforcers at PAX Oz, every year at the after party, they always make sure that I have something that is Australian, that is like distinctly Australian. And so one, it was some kind of a delight. It was like a whipped cream dessert that had it was like a horned melon seeds or something on it. Yes, pavlova, that's it. And I like all the stuff they bring me. At the very first one that we did, we like made fairy bread. Yeah. Right? And I was like, and this is normal for you. Right? And I'm not even bagging on it, but it's just like at your birthday, like your mom will make you this. And I was like, fuck yeah. That's kind of hot. And then.
No, it's great. Means I can throw another modifier at you. Answer the next question like you're trying to hide the alien you discovered in a nearby cornfield from your weirdly young hot.
Okay, we will do that. But
is
here,
that, is
but
that
here.
From a movie?
But, so yeah, the very last going, one going. Before the bad times was the HSP, and so it's a whole to-go box, like a whole styrofoam to-go box, fries in the bottom, chips. Atop this is layers of gyro meat.
Yeah.
With like a chili sauce and like a cream sauce, and then different places have make them slightly differently. But there's also like some cheese in there.
I must have it.
It's fucked.
You told me about it without.
It's the best drunk food ever.
Without the acronym, you told me about it without the acronym.
Oh, I told you about the
and
halal
I couldn't
snack
get
pack.
There. Yes. But what's the KSP then?
I don't think that's real. I think that's something that he just does in his basement.
That's kosher snack pack. Kosher, yeah. It's just a little different. That's all.
Kerbal, yeah, okay.
Kerbal. All right, 4 for me. 1, 2, 3, 4. Take a box for number 3. Not. Forget it. Go for it. Okay, it's like something. What is it? You're hiding an alien from a hot wife.
A wizard from the Gold Coast asks, "Please tell us a secret only Americans know."
About the alien in the corner.
Oh yeah, I was just gonna say. Well, I mean, I can tell you what we don't have, Mom. The main thing that you have to know, don't come back, like don't come back here. My room is messy. And I want to be a good son. And I want to be a great son. I want to be an incredible son. I want to be the son that you want, Mom. I want you to love me again.
Son, what's wrong with you?
No, I want you to love me again, Mom. I know that Dad left us, and I feel like he left me first. But
you have to feed it.
Yeah.
It's getting angry. Oh wait, yeah, okay. Little one, nothing for me.
Ciao. 1, 2, 3, 4, plane. Annette Brown from Perth, originally, asks, my hair is dull and lifeless.
It's not a question.
There's an upper bound on how much I can help you with this, Annette. My hairdresser says there's nothing I can do because my mother is Maltese. Kris has amazing hair. Does he have any advice for me? The hair game is pretty live.
I guess don't be Maltese, maybe? There's nothing to be done. It's just thick, half Egyptian, locks, beautiful. I think it improved, though, having not cut my hair for 3 years, at least here.
Well, no, because the crazy thing about it is it's like your hair is a fractal construct, because you had like the certain hair shape, and then it retained its like shape, it just became more vast.
Yeah, each hair is more heads, more
yes.
tiny hairs.
That's okay. Right.
Six.
Oh, hey.
Right. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Take a box of number 5, but I'm not.
Number 5, the beast. Doc.
You want to do a little math? Great. Me too. I love math.
Okay.
So, what's your birthday? Because I don't know. And add up all the numbers, and then add those 4 numbers together before I count to 10.
What?
1, 2, 3.
That was easy.
What?
4.
That's very straightforward.
5, 6, 7, 8.
Wait, why is there so much calculation? I don't understand. I'm not good at math, but...
9.
Did I do it
10.
Wrong?
Time's up! If you failed,
15.
Turn to the audience and let them boo you. If you succeeded, roll the dice. If you get a 5 or a 6, you can take a box of words.
Oh, come on. Oh, come on. Nah! Oh, I mean, yay, I got one.
Oh, you got a box. Well, which one do you want?
No, I didn't get one. I did not get one. Dude.
Whole
time.
God damn it.
5. All right, let's see what we get. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Oh, okay, I thought it was going to go in the hole. Strange fella from Sad Place asks, everything sucks, and yet we must continue on.
True.
I honestly have been in need of, really need of some good news or friendly conversation, or just a thing to point towards as that'll be good when it comes.
Yeah.
So we're missing that, just looking forward. What do you use for this sort of centering? What gives you hope for humanity? I think that the fact that we are here still continuing on, you know,
yeah.
we're still trying.
Absolutely.
People will always try. It's
yeah.
not everybody who's a piece of shit.
No.
Right. And you have an opportunity to be even more of not a piece of shit every day.
Absolutely.
To my child.
You can always do it the other way.
Yeah.
You can start whenever you want.
Yeah.
Also, Steam Decks are now shipping in real time.
Yeah.
So that's something to consider.
Something to look forward to.
Now, I have to roll a 6 to get out, but I already took this, and then Mike did his bullshit, so I got it. That's the number 4. Now, Dan, a.k.a. that 8-bit workshop guy from a really beautiful spot, turn left at Spencer Street and walk west for 625 hours, asks, I know where that is. I turn right on Spencer Street on Flinders Lane, and that's how I get to the laneway where Mensusai Mugen is. Jerry, what would you say is the prime mechanic of Warhammer 40K gameplay that has also kept your interest for all these years? Also, have you considered replacing your hands with Kiko's severed hands to steal his painting skills? Or are you worried about inheriting the demonic pact he has signed with forces unspeakable? No, he just cares a lot. There's no crossroads bargain with Satan. He just cares a lot. And he also has a lot of unique tools. Have you ever seen him paint?
I've never watched him paint.
He has a little dryer. He plugs in a USB hub when he paints. He has a light, He has a head-mounted lit magnifying
thing. And the lens
thing.
And all that? Yeah.
Yes. He has a little fan, a little drying fan that he uses to dry the miniatures.
Oh, I love it.
To cut down time between layers. It's crazy. It's like Sharper Image.
Yeah.
It's just like the first 10 pages of the Sharper Image catalog. What is the prime mechanic of Warhammer 40K, my friends? The gameplay has changed a lot in different ways all the time. The main thing is that it's really just the barest hint of an excuse to get around a table and play with our dolls. And, you know,
no,
that's,
I get
that's,
it.
That's plenty.
Here, wait, I got a... Oh, wait, I did roll this while you had been speaking. Let's see if I get in a hole.
That's fine.
One, two, three, four, five, six. Oh, plane. All right, here we go. The crystalline entity from Wherever the Eatin's Good asks, if Dr. Noonien Soong had created RoboCop to clean up DS9, could he do it? I mean, it seems to me that apparently in Star Trek it was a big deal to make a positronic brain.
Yeah, but or else could, it'd be everywhere.
But you could just stick a human brain into a thing and just have it go to town. Also, he's in the question, clean up DS9. I assume it's just like, you know.
It's purely a
RoboMop.
Yeah. Five, hey, that's pretty, that's almost six.
That's pretty nice.
Fuck this hole, man.
One, take a box if you're number one.
You're
not,
not, though, so you know what? Two, also not six.
Four. Four. One, two, three, four, nothing.
Hole.
Nothing doing.
Ha! One, two, three, four, five, six. The number of the beast. No, listen. Ironically,
yeah, you clear your own hole.
If someone else had gotten here, it's like I'm getting my own self out of the hole. It's a causality thing, ultimately.
Do we have to collect all of these to proceed?
I don't think so. I think there's other opportunities, and obviously we want to see all the content.
That's true, because we have an hour to play this, but then is it a little bit longer, this panel? Are we going a little bit longer to do this?
I don't think so.
Really?
We got 60 minutes total.
Right.
We want to get as many of these as we can so that we're armed for the finale.
Okay.
Right?
That's just a question of when it happens.
Exactly right. Once one person enters the final challenge, everyone's in. You both must participate. Nobody can collect any more boxes. So,
oh, I see. You're up. You may be like, I'll pull the trigger now.
Yes, and it might be that something changes because we're supposed to move that many squares clockwise. I mean, I don't consider going around like this and then going in clockwise. I feel like that's not what clocks do.
Yeah, oh, okay. Whose turn is it?
Fuck off.
As a swing.
I love it, Daddy. I love it.
I love it.
You're going to have to do better than that.
I love it, Daddy. I love it.
I
love it, Daddy!
I love it! I love it.
Well, I'm gonna have to put it to a vote. Hands up if everyone thought that was good. Hands up everyone who thought he could do better and should roll a six.
Nope.
Well, I wasn't looking at the hands.
Well, there's your answer. Bye, I guess.
Yeah, it turned out okay. Thank you. Don't give him what he wants.
No, we'll keep playing. I ignore reality. We're just going to do it.
Jab.
Did I? Oh, wait. Was it me or you? I think I got that right. Okay.
Dark. The naked, spotless intellect without circumference or center from where all things are like the void and cloudless sky asks, Kris, since you basically inspired it.
So many words.
I know, that's a lot. This is one of your fans, that's how you can tell. Kris, since you basically inspired it via Local 58, the daddy of the Genray, how do you feel about the surge of analog horror ARG series being made recently by the Zoomies? I assume that means Zoomers?
The children.
You know what they don't like being called? Zillennials. hate it. They hate it, and that's why you have to do it. And do you have any favorites? What elements of that type of horror do you find most terrifying, and what elements have you seen that don't work yet?
Gosh, this is a great question. I don't know if it should be answered within the confines of this game. I may answer it at my panel at five.
Ho, ho. We have 20 minutes,
yeah.
Certainly. But
No. I'll go real quick. I think that it's inspiring to see people get interested in a thing and then they're like, I'm gonna make that. I want to make that.
Yes.
Because that's the reason why I've done anything. It's like, I like that, but I didn't like this part. I'll do it
exactly.
Differently.
This is the most healthy approach.
That's cool and great. But like, much like in webcomics, you are seeing people like learn on the job.
Yes.
And so when somebody's very excited and they're 12 years old and they push out this thing and it's like, this is good, right? And it just uses all of the tropes with no rotation.
That's how it starts.
You have to start there. Yeah.
If you look at like, because I've seen it, and I think that Mike has even posted it. If you look at Mike's first comic, it's Garfield.
Hmm. Oh, yeah.
That's, and I think that there's a lot of comics like that.
You have to start there.
By 12-year-olds.
Yeah.
Right? Except that 12-year-olds now have access to non-linear editing tools.
Oh,
for free at home.
No, speaking of, and goes with this question.
Yeah, Unreal Engine.
Yeah, my pick for a cool one, and people know it already, probably is Backrooms by Kane Pixels. That guy's like 17 years old.
Exactly.
And he did one, the first one out, the gate was 10 minutes long, and there's no fat on it. It's amazing.
No, every frame of it is on purpose.
It's so well made.
Yeah.
It's incredible.
Yeah, they're going to do all right.
Yeah, inspiring.
Joe. Oh, plain. Minor character, whose only notable quality is knowing Latin, from Neptunian orbit, asks, I know a shortcut to Alpha Centauri. Sure. It requires passing through actual hell, but it's not like we'd be staying there. Do you have a better idea? I mean, I'm down.
Well, how you gotta check your hell shield. Make sure that's up as you're going through.
Yeah, exactly. Make sure that it's active.
Yeah, you just, on, hell shield on.
Exactly.
Can we not do this again? All right, two.
Jerry.
All right.
One, two, three, X.
I was gonna say, is this still engaging content?
I'm having a great time.
I can't hear any more of this. If either of you are on a gravestone with an X, you get two free turns. Yeah, great, good job, whatever.
Chekhov's X came
home. Thanks, man. You know what? I said a lot of bad stuff about you before. One, two, three. Think a box for your number two, I'm not. Two, all right, well now enjoy yourself.
Thank you.
I really made the most of it.
Two, dark. No. Steve from Wesley asks, I don't, that sometimes happens with a matched apostrophe. There's a Euro symbol and a trademark. I don't look like anyone in my family. Turns out that's because I put something up my nose as a kid, and it's still there. My face distorted around it. The object is the size of a pearl, not made of metal. We don't know what it is. It is being removed on Tuesday. What is your guess? Winner keeps it.
It's the size of a pearl?
Yeah.
Oh, I mean, I definitely 100% had to go to the hospital because I filled my my ear canal with rocks. We had a we were just like, you know how it is. It's like, what do you want to do? Well, let's put a bunch of rocks in our ears.
Yeah.
And then this happened to Brenna too. Brenna had put a piece of sponge like up into her sinus, and it was there so long that it began to rot and stink to the extent that people outside of her could smell it.
Wow.
And then they took her to the hospital. I'm just saying that you put things up your nose. My guess is that it's probably a marble.
I'm going to guess a battleship because I don't want to win and I do not want to keep it.
You mean like a real battleship?
Yeah.
The Nimitz.
An actual.
Nothing.
Two. Oh, I get a plane. Jad from Gogglebox asks, to what extent would you say House of the Dragon restored the reputation of Game of Thrones? I have not seen any of it, and I don't know that it did. I read a lot of stuff about how, no, thank you, to House of the Dragon.
There's so much hot shit. Like, there's so much hot shit to watch.
I'm not
out here trying to watch a prequel to something that they blew up.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Even
it's like, let's say that it was great. Let's say that it was great, right? It's like, that just provides a bridge to a destroyed realm.
Right.
It's just like, oh, well, what's after this? Well, shit.
You already went there.
Six. One, two, three, four, five, six. Ozzy. Oi, oi, oi. Frank Walker. From National Tiles asks,
I'm back, Mike. Thanks, Mike. Whoa. It's good to be back. Hey, Mike, what do you think we should do this time? I don't know. Maybe have them roll. Put up a list of outcomes. Great idea, Mike.
Oh, jeez. All right.
All right,
let's each roll.
Oh.
two is?
Plain card.
I miss, oh no, dark card for me, all right.
Yeah.
That's nice, worked out okay.
Yeah, that's really good, no. Do Americans use imperial measurements for everything, or do shops sell a wide range of floor coverings for less than $8 per meter?
That's some inside baseball.
I love it. I think this is great content. Do we ever, are there any contexts where we use metric?
Metric?
That are normal?
Physics?
No. Well, no. Yeah. Like for cocaine. I mean, that's like, it's
yeah, you have to cater to that market,
yeah,
the international
exactly.
space.
It's an international market. Go for it.
I don't have to buy a pound of cocaine. What is that?
Yeah, exactly. That's too much.
Jacko from Frangers or Frangers? Frangers asks, what item of clothing can I wear that will make me irresistible to women around the age of 30? Well, I mean, I sell this, this leather. I actually have no idea. I have no idea. You can, suspenders could work. I feel like it has to be indicative, whatever the thing is, of like something that's appealing. Like maybe a shirt that says, that's like your Tinder profile. That's it, a shirt that says, I'm a nice guy. That'll do it.
Yeah.
And a fedora.
Yeah, do the full meal deal, really reel them in. Fish Monkey Hat from the audience asks, how often do you name a comic only to find out that you've already used that name? It's happened maybe 4 times in like 3,000 comics. I have a part of the database I can use to search for that now.
Yeah, that's super
because
useful.
My engineer is very cool.
I forget where we were.
I got it.
You go for it.
Un, deux, trois, quatre. Fish Monkey Hat's back. From the audience says, Jerry or Kris, have you ever seen something IRL that shouldn't be?
Well, like if I have like a mole that I gotta get removed?
Yeah,
like,
yeah, exactly.
Like, sure.
Something
have you
that...
ever seen something that you had to fix? Oh, sure, yeah. That happens
well,
frequently.
I think it's the idea.
Yeah. Oh, spooky, okay.
Yeah, yeah, something that you wish were not IRL.
I've seen movies that are kind of spooky, and those are real. I mean, I watch them.
Yeah, even the US remake of The Ring ruined me for about a week.
Oh, like, yeah, that's not I assume that's not the tenor of the question, but that's fine.
Well,
I've never
no,
seen
it. I wish that I wish, even this pretend thing I wish weren't real, because it got to the point where I had to sleep. I couldn't even sleep in the room with Brenna because I wanted to protect her from the ghost.
Right.
And so I slept on the couch facing the only entrance with all the lights on, looking at the edge.
Oh, we love our rituals, don't we?
Yeah.
I have two of these, I think. Oh, one was a ring. This one's a better one, though. Before I had really gotten interested in horror, like I always was, but I didn't. It wasn't like a thing
yeah.
for me. But I saw The Sixth Sense, and the sequences with the ghost where the ghost forgets that the child is not her husband and stuff like that. And
hey, fellas, how's it hanging?
I love it, Daddy. I'm in the middle of a story.
Who's got the most word boxes? Really? Send yourself to the hole.
Now.
Ah. No, but like I was so upset by that idea that night I slept on the couch and I put the blanket full over me, which I like to do anyway, but this
yeah.
was a heavy blanket. I made myself delirious from heat.
From oxygen?
And I believed that I was possessed currently, but I thought, that would be good because if I got one ghost in, then no other ghost can get in.
You were like at maximum, no vacancy?
Right, it's like, I'll deal with this one, but I don't want like a airport in here. Okay, so you're in a hole.
I guess.
Two. Oh, wait, did I go or are you?
No, it's your turn.
Okay.
I'm in this freaking hole.
Okay, Aussie.
Aussie.
Matt from Sydney asks, my wife thinks I have traveled to Melbourne for a real estate conference this weekend. It is my fifth time using this lie. She thinks I'm having an affair. Will you please assure her my adultery is purely platonic?
Yes.
Matt is seeing a secret friend a secret, you know, 50,000 friends, I
yeah,
guess.
Yeah, yeah, it's a platonic orgy.
Yeah.
For
it's
lack of a better
It's an orgy
term.
Of friends.
Yeah, exactly.
Sorry.
It's a low impact orgy.
That's a divorce.
Does that help? Yes.
Yeah.
six, it's the number of the beast. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Now, what I am wondering is if we should start to move into
this. Shush! Shush!
Wait, we're getting a director.
Stop talking.
Okay.
This next question needs to be answered by one person while the other reaches their hands through their armpits and wiggles them around.
Okay, let's see who's up.
Deal.
That.
Here, so this is it. No, you go, and then we'll do this. I'm just wondering if we should move, start to move into the center.
I think
center.
Maybe we should. Oh, I think I avoided the hole. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Aussie. So you are going to
yeah,
be
I got
behind
you.
Me.
Yep, here, no, give me a question.
Oh, yeah, okay, and then I'll go like this. Here, let's go up front.
Yeah.
Okay.
All right, here's this. I physically can't
just
beat it.
Just tuck in.
Here, right?
Thank you. I'm very full today. Martin Holdsworth from Melbourne asks, I am a dual US-Australian citizen. I want to try living in the old country for a couple years, but I'm afraid of change. What American cities are most like Melbourne? I'm a comforting person. What American cities, this is a good question. I think that I've often described, yeah, it's a great one, Martin. Thanks for sending these in. And if anybody wants to keep this card, I'll just toss it out into the audience. So anyway, I always had a bad, well, it's time for me to tell you the truth about how I feel about the, you over there especially, you've got to get my watch repaired like I told you to. So, I often have said that Seattle is like if the U.S. Said, let's make Melbourne here, and then they did like a 20th of the job. Like, it's not, it tried hard to be as cool, but it didn't do that, so.
that was very, pretty fucking engaging.
That was very comforting.
Here, ready. Now, you can't actually get in there from here. Oh, this is perfect.
Yeah, there
if
you
I
go.
If I get the number of the beast, then
okay.
We get in there, right?
Yeah, I can try to, I'll also try to sidle in. Actually, it's in my best interest not to. Dark, let's go.
Because as long as one of us gets in, we both get in.
Right, we have to do it. Tommy Waxman from Rattleaid asks,
Rattleaid?
I bought the Cyberpunk 2077 Collector's Edition from a scalper on eBay for $600.
Right now. Oh, you? How's it hanging?
I love it, Daddy, I love it. I'm loving it.
Guess what, pal? It's time for the lightning round.
Oh,
pick up the dice. Every time you roll it, I'm gonna give you a number. If you roll the number, you get a box of words.
Oh,
and
geez.
If you fail, you miss
okay.
One turn.
Okay,
let's
we go.
Let's practice. Show me one. Get it?
God damn it.
This is for real. Let's see a six now. How about a three?
What? Oh, he rattled through them. That's not it. And then a
okay,
four.
The first was a six. We got that.
And then I missed one. And then there was a four and a five.
Six, three.
All right, three. Nope. Four. Nope.
And then two.
Two. Nope. Yeah. I thought last one was five. Didn't get any others.
Nope.
Okay.
So grab you. Did you snatch a box?
I did take a box.
Box snatcher.
Pretty nice. Oh, what personal purchase have you regretted most? Was the rest of that question? God, that's a good question. I buy a lot of devices. That's my failure. I buy a lot of gaming devices. The Steam Deck has obliterated
Stop.
That. There's
okay.
no reason.
Each what? Of you roll the dice.
Yeah.
Whoever rolls highest gets a box of words. Yeah, I know you like that. Daddy provides.
All right, ready?
Oh, love it, Daddy.
Oh. Number the fucking beast.
I see. Now they're gonna backload
now
these boxes.
Number of the beast.
Okay, two. Oh. Can I migrate in like this? Let me take a, I'll take a plane. Carrie from the Project asks, in the Variety Act hierarchy, it is widely acknowledged that jugglers rank above stilt walkers, but below card trick magicians. Which Variety Act would you say is at the very bottom? I took a history of television class in college, and at the very beginning, when there was a lot of Variety Act stuff, they somehow had a lot of people jumping on trampolines. Like, they had never seen this before. Like people jumping on trampolines,
just going roaring, real high,
and not like flipping over, just fucking as high as they can.
I think we know what that was about.
That sucks. All right.
Okay. So we just got to get in here.
Okay.
Here, just come in here. Okay. Time is wasting. Right, oh, look. That's parfait.
I have to go. Yep. Yeah, like that. All right.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Oh, you piece of fucking shit.
Okay. Let's see what I could do. Two. All right, we're still in it.
We love what we're seeing. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Dang. Circling the drain. Come on, 3. Nope.
Roll your number to play again. Hit
so
it.
I want a 3.
Yeah.
Come on, 3.
Well, you want a 2, because your number is 2.
Here. 1, 2, 3, 4. All right, so go ahead.
2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Son of a beeswax.
This is even
We can't let him beat us. Go.
Worse than the rest of the thing. 3. Miss a turn.
Ow, miss a turn. All right, then now you go.
Okay. Yeah, 6. Jeez, I'm gonna have to make an entire lap to do this. 3, 4, 5, 6.
Dark. I think we just passed.
You're
back
just going
forth.
Through here?
This is a joust situation. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yep.
Yeah, I'm not
gonna. Once you're inside, you can't go
this.
Clockwise anymore.
All right, I'm
work.
Gonna come back this way, even though it's a cheat. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5?
Yeah, I need a 1. That's a 2.
Damn it. Oops, sorry, that was your
miss
one.
A turn.
Miss a turn.
Great.
Jesus Christ.
1.
Michael.
All right, now.
What happens?
The final challenge. Once one person enters, we both enter. You both must participate. Nobody can collect any more boxes of words okay. or move about the board. Roll your die.
Okay.
Whatever the number you roll is, the number of words you have to write a story that scares your counterpart.
Okay.
And we have basic words here.
All right. How are you supposed to do this with 2?
I'm gonna do my best.
I have 2 also, so it's fair.
All right, ready?
Yeah, let me shake these out, take a peek. This is the real fun of the game for the audience. Sorting words, labeling. Yeah, get into it.
Son of a.
Shh. About to be losing time, dummies. If you don't get your act together soon, it's gonna be kind of depressing. You don't wanna disappoint all these fine people, do you?
Come on, we're doing it. I got some. There's some good ideas in here. Okay. Finding some cool stuff. I don't even need any of these simple words. There's plenty of great concepts here.
Yes. Okay. All right.
Gosh, I wish it was 3. I could do so much more with 3. I could do 33% more with 3. All right. So we have like 30 seconds
yes.
at this point. All right, let me just take a quick lap.
All right, you ready?
Yeah, I'm ready. God, there's so much good on the table. Thank you.
Congratulations
Ready?
On not winning, losers. I somehow knew this would happen. I guess I'll go on to drink my cranberry juice in victory.
Sure.
Ha! Oh!
Cheers! Sweet tasty.
Okay. The traditional Vermont use.
All
oh,
right.
thank you. Let's
you
just
ready?
Do a reveal. I already revealed it by accident.
Here.
Show me.
Dead internet. Sorry, we got the trailer credits.
No. Just show me yours, because I have a feeling you're going to win.
Ready? Dead internet.
Right. That's
this is how
to scare you
terrified me.
You're the winner. Jerry Holkins, ladies and gentlemen.
Oh my gosh. What an absolute pleasure.
What a treat.
Welcome back to PAX Australia, everybody. It's been a minute, for sure. Thanks so much for rolling through, spending time with me and my friend Kris. Thanks so much to Mike, who did that, and I didn't even know about it. And also, thanks to our game master, Laura from work. A couple more days of the show. Go enjoy yourselves.